Those statistics can be scary, and you might feel like you're being bitten and kicked by a pack of confusing names and numbers. These words fly off the screen in a scary way. ANOVA, MODE, PROBABILITY, CHI-SQUARED, MANN-WHITNEY U-TEST, and CONFOUNDING VARIABLES. They can also be useful if you are able to tame this information and put it to good use. Factor analysis is a statistical test that is used to figure out if unobserved variables may be influencing observed variables. It is used to identify which factors explain a variety of results. One of the first examples of this technique is an action involved Charles Spearman, who discovered that school children's scores on a wide variety of seemingly unrelated subjects were positively correlated. These observations led him to postulate that a general mental ability, or G, underlies and shapes human cognitive performance, or IQ. In this example, the G is the unobserved variable and the factor that is influencing the children's subject scores. The subject scores are their observed variables. There are two types of factor analysis: exploratory factor analysis, EFA, and confirmatory factor analysis, CFA. Just like it sounds, EFA attempts to discover the nature of the constructs influencing a set of responses, while CFA attempts to confirm that a specified set of constructs is influencing responses in an expected way. The common factor model illustrates how this method works. In this method, observed responses are represented in measures 1 through 5. Underlying unique factors are represented by E1 and 5, and the underlying common factors are represented by factor 1 and 2. The strength of the relationship between each factor and measure varies, indicating that some factors influence variables more than others. Measures that are highly correlated are likely influenced by the same factors. Those that are uncorrelated are likely influenced by different factors. If the factors were perfectly correlated, there would be a score of 1, and if they were perfectly negative correlated, there would be a score of negative 1. How about checking out 1 in action? In Leisure, Lifestyles, and Health-Related Quality of Life of Taiwanese Adults by Ming-Ching Yang, Jingzhong Xin, and Xinwen Yu, this study analyzes the relationship between various leisure lifestyle variables and quality of life outcomes. Peterson Gunn of 2004 defined leisure lifestyles as a leisure-related attitudes, perception, behavior, performance in the environment of daily life based on experiences of daily life. The leisure lifestyle variables investigated include preferred travel, self-realization, morning action, exercise loving, homebody, social support. For all these measures, a higher score indicated a greater activity level. Ferens, 1996, developed a model to measure quality of life, which includes the following variables: health and functioning, psychological disturbances, tranquility, conscious health state, social character and function. Due to past findings, it was hypothesized that more active leisure lifestyles would be correlated with higher measures of well-being. 662 valid surveys were returned from a convenience sample of the urban-suburban Taiwanese population. The results, the leisure lifestyle scores of the samples, were used to cluster the sample population into 4 groups. The static recreation group, 30%, the traveling and social group, 27%, the active exerciser group, 18%, and the morning exercisers, 25%. When the 4 groups were analyzed for demographic differences, it was found that there were more men than women in the morning exercisers and active exerciser groups. The morning exercisers also tended to be older. The traveling and social group was made up mostly of females, and over half of that group were unmarried. The active exercisers tended to be younger, motivated by challenge and self-actualization, and lived mainly in the city. Correlations between the leisure lifestyles and overall well-being. The early morning exercisers had the highest scores related to mental health and reported few emotional-based problems, while the static, less active group had the lowest scores. Also, the active exercisers and early morning exercisers were more likely to access their health as good and to report feeling more energetic more often. Overall, the least healthy group was the static recreation group, who were less physically active and less social than the other groups. Recommendations? The authors concluded that these results suggest that the government of Taiwan should actively promote health-related physical fitness and both the short and long-term benefits of active leisure. It was also suggested that promoting more active leisure lifestyles could possibly reduce healthcare expenditures for the aging Taiwanese population. Thank you for listening.